Morning, James.
Morning, Bizzard.
Wake up. Run, rush, and put a little makeup. Had the sense to fade away this hiccup. Why'd you leave the keys up on the table? Here you go, create another table. You wanted to. Grab a rush and put a little makeup. You wanted to.
Looks good. Yeah.
He always looks good.
Thanks, Busy. Transition.
Big dog in the brand new office.
Love the outfit.
Thank you very much.
He's got the nice
jeans.
Yeah.
Just some jeans on.
Where does this go?
Where does what go? Where does that go? Why don't you find out, big boy? How you been? Good?
Good.
Yeah?
Yeah, can't complain.
Well,
we got time?
We got time.
No, we're good. So, started early this morning. PTs. With Mr. Jay Cutler.
Paul. Nice.
Had a check-in with Hayden.
How's he going?
He's good.
What's he like, 27?
27 weeks out. He's probably the heaviest and leanest he's ever been. So he's good, he's on track. So it'll be I'm pretty excited for him prepping for his first pro show, international pro show. So in New Zealand that we step on stage. And he's gonna be bigger and leaner, and he's moving well in terms of his exercise execution and stuff like that. His mobility through certain areas is really good, so we're seeing that improvement in his physique. And we've got his diet sort of calories out to a really good point where he's consuming a decent amount of food and he's not showing signs of resistance to it, sort of thing, so no digestional stress or anything like that, which is good. So pretty excited for that one. I've coached Hayden for like 7 years, so it's just as invested in it as he is. Because I've obviously seen him progress, get the pro card, and now we just want to stamp in that sort of federation and that division for him. What else? Well, bits happened since you haven't been here, so we obviously got mirrors. Posing mirrors.
Hello.
I think it's just little cosmetic things have been happening, like the painting and stuff like that has been happening.
I think last I was here...
I think we got the TV working, you're here yesterday.
Yeah, TV's up and running now.
It's just little things that have been happening.
Yep.
What else? I'd be a very boring day in the life, wouldn't I?
No. I literally spend a day with you and it's pretty entertaining.
Yeah.
It is pretty entertaining.
Day in the life of James. Try to get me in a room, yeah. Everybody wanna talk, why? Always coming with the tunes, They know I'ma take it far, right? Something I already knew, yeah. Never needed your applause, nah. They been saying it's a fluke, This is not a false alarm, nah, it's not. How have I been? I've been good, Biz.
Yeah? Just nice and settled into the new office now?
Yeah, man, like, it'll be good once the glass goes in. Glass goes in 2 weeks, but...
Beautiful.
Yeah, really starting to find our flow here. Like, it's all working really well. Athletes are fucking loving it. So much better than the last place too, because like you can overlook the floor and interact with people. So like on the days you just back to back the calls, you don't feel so isolated from everyone. So yeah. Well, hopefully the cameras get done soon, so we'll have a monitor up there and we can see the whole gym.
Oh, beautiful! That's great.
Well, so
yeah, that's a good idea.
Let us keep a better eye on people.
Yeah, beautiful. How's your day looking? Good.
Yeah, day's looking. It's hectic.
Yeah.
Like been going all morning. I've got Josh and Kat to actually call now. Beck's coming in, which will be her 30th this week, but that's what we're doing the whole shred for. So
yes, right.
And she's had a pretty rough couple of weeks in and out of hospital. And commitment to us, she's managed to stick to everything, even with the trips to hospital. So
good on her.
Like, she sent through photos on Monday, and like, she's looking the best she ever has. She looks stage ready, really. So
damn.
Yeah, pretty keen to do her pinches today, checking with Davina. And then I think Jimmy's going to do the mentoring for us today because I have a new client coming in.
Beautiful.
And then we got physio on Kyra today too, because after the couple of weeks of moving and that and the abuse the body's taken.
Oh, you're gonna need it.
Oh, I'm nervous about seeing Laura, man. Those needles are gonna fucking hurt.
It'll be interesting to see what she says.
Yeah, I might cry like a little bitch in that one. And then, yeah, I'm actually back here tonight. So normally Friday nights I try not come in because like every second week that's when I have Stephen. But yeah, just a few new people joined the team. It's the only time I can get them in. So I'll be here till about 9 o'clock tonight just checking in with people. So
perfect.
Should be good. Try to get me in a room, yeah. Everybody wanna talk, why? Always coming with the tunes, They know I'ma take it far, right? Something I already knew. It's still holding nice and lean for the stomach, like, because during the last 2 weeks you had, you held it together real well, eh? You haven't wasted away, still hold nice and tight. Flat your stomach, isn't that? Like,
pretty much not far from what you did today, so I'm stoked. So from last time we pinched in, because you'd been sick and under eating, you're up 1.3 kilos at lean mass. Fatness is the same.
Oh, fatness is the same?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so lean is more like what, muscle mass?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, like, it's lean mass, whether it's muscle glycogen. So a lot of it would be more muscle glycogen because you'd lost all that lean mass when you were sick and unable to eat. So just getting all the foods and that back in, that's all back on, and you put up, well, you're down 0.2% body fat, so you're pinching at 10.9.
Okay, cool.
So that's good.
That's good.
Well, considering the couple of weeks you've had, not many people will come in and still be better.
Okay.
So like, the way you've kind of managed the food and that through what was going on.
Yeah. Like, awesome.
Fucking stoked with.
Alright, so middle tension point is the normal mid-range through the movement. Number three would be in sort of the what you call like the lengthened position. So the stretch down the bottom, there's going to be added tension down there. And number two is the short position, so the contraction and stuff like that. So depending on where you place the weight is where you feel the most amount of tension. With James at the moment, we've got the weight position through the, predominantly through the mid-range, so just a standard sort of movement pattern, and then we put a little bit extra right in that stretch position at the bottom, force me into that stretch position a little bit deeper than he normally would be.
Thank you for the knowledge.
Here to help. James, what do you think?
Do you like the new machine?
Yeah, I do. Do you like business outfit today? Yeah, I thought the same thing. You're not sure about the shoes, are you?
There's really not much effort,
Connie. Really not much effort. It just looks like something together, doesn't it? Yeah.
Sorry, I'll bring my fuzzy slippers with me next time. How was your check-in?
Look, it's not a bad check-in. It's exactly the same, actually. So there's some fluctuations. Remus started a new job, and his hours are fluctuating. Early starts, late finishes, all that sort of thing. So it's just trying to find a balance slash structure that's going to work for him in terms of obviously getting the food in, working in with a training schedule, and then sleep schedule too. So, like, we would have expected it to be probably worse than what it is, but it's pretty good. There is consistency with the food going in, but in terms of clean foods, not shit foods or anything like that. So, well. But over the next couple of weeks, we're just going to really hone in on a schedule that hopefully fits.
I mean, one of our clients, Mick, gave it to us, and he'd been sitting in the office about 4 months.
Yeah.
Because we weren't going to set up in the old joint. And then, we lost the remote for it.
Could be anywhere. Could be anywhere.
Well, and it's like, everything that we didn't bring here has been thrown out, so, yeah, we're not getting that back.
Yeah.
Let's go!
Pee on your own time, Jay.
Count them out.
Oh.
I was actually impressed. Yeah. What we're going to talk about today, we went over back, a little bit of back execution.
Yes.
Another one I really want to look into is shoulders.
Okay.
And shoulder pressing in particular. Okay? So what's the first thing we look at when we're pressing? What's the key cues that we'd use?
The position of their elbows and their wrists.
Yeah. What else? If we also look at core stability, stuff like that. So obviously they're bracing.
Yeah.
What about the bar path as well?
Whether it's direct or.
Yeah, hand position and that comes in it, but how deep we go into that?
Yeah.
Into the movement.
Yeah.
And why do we look at that?
So that we're getting the full range. Motion.
Yep, but also we're making sure we're not jeopardizing anything as well. So like shoulder health.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, so probably what's one thing, a couple of key points we look at?
Just creating a stable environment, so stability. So core stability, making sure everything's sort of locked in, depressed scapula, everything's in good positioning.
Gee, why don't you put Hayden into the movement? Ooh. Put him through the movement. Tell him where to put his hands, tell him to position his shoulders, and be retracted, or what's where does it help?
Stabilize your
feet. And what does that do? Allows us to generate more force. Up. Cool?
Yep.
Okay, so feet presses now. To press up. Okay. You tell me when to stop. From there.
To there.
Okay. Why there?
Because his hands are next to his ears.
A little bit of, how would you say, ease in terms of that movement, but it does change the angle of the movement as well.
Yeah.
So if someone can't press out in that position because they're really uncomfortable, do that.
Yeah.
It's generally for a purpose.
Yeah.
But I'd say most people, you want them pressing in a normal sort of position like that.
Yeah.
And then it's like, okay, cool, you notice something, like they can't get the stretch out there or they're feeling uncomfortable. Well, there's something to work on as well.
Go in.
Very dependent.
Yeah.
You can have an illusion on anyone because then it comes down to where you're positioning yourself. Okay?
Okay, yeah.
So jump up and show me how you do it.
So,
yep.
I'll just go from there and hinge back.
Okay.
Until I sort of feel like that's my bottom range and then drive through.
Cool. Let's try this, okay? So if we go up into your top position, let's depress the scapula.
Yep.
Let's imagine we're pushing your arms or pushing into the bars, okay?
Yep.
Do you know what that's doing? It's locking in your lats.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Okay, now we're going to force your hips back.
Yeah.
Okay, so force your hips back. Do you feel the stretch? Feel the stretch?
Yep.
Okay, cool.
Back up.
Back up. Now, let's do it again. So depress your shoulder blades, pushing hard into the bar so it's locking on your lats.
Yeah.
I want you to push back until you feel the stretch there. Good. Okay, now I want you to bring your hips forward and I want you to lock your quads.
Lock my quads.
Lock your quads. Okay. We don't want to come all the way through enough. That's a thrust.
Yeah.
We want to lock the quads.
Yeah.
So we're finishing that movement with the hip hinge.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So depress the shoulders, lats on, push. There you go. Lock the quads.
Cool.
Good. Let's go one more. So 1, 2, 3. Pause. Up. Good.
That's fucking hard, hey.
Yeah.
What would you do in terms of foot positioning for front facing?
As in like
a squat.
V squat?
Yeah.
Two things. It depends on someone's ability and their hip movement, you know, the flexibility to the hips and how they need it to move. So generally I go straight out, but I might need to turn them slightly out so they can push their knees out to get that.
Yeah. Do you still like have them towards the back of the platform?
Yeah, so again, you imagine like the V squat we just did, the front squat. Yep. So imagine bar, the load is straight down over the top of you.
Yeah.
Same thing as here. You want them straight under the. Underneath. Make sense?
Action.
Snip. So we just had a PT coaching mentoring sort of session. Sort of an opportunity to sit down with some of the. Well, not sit down, go. Meet up with a couple of coaches and go through some movement patterns that we see that are executed probably poorly on the gym floor, so they can just take that sort of those cues and those points back to their clients and sort of reiterate them and make sure everything's being executed properly. Keegz generally does a lot of the mentoring in terms of you know, the training, nutrition and stuff like that, but my turn to contribute a little bit in terms of the mentoring of our staff. So yeah, most of them are pretty good in terms of how they cue their clients. It's just refining certain movements and any questions they might have in terms of how to cue someone if they're struggling to feel a movement or execute a movement properly.
Keegz, what are we up to over here?
Man, I just loaded episode 12, man.
Ooh, 12 or? Yeah, 12.
12. I fit 12 up first,
that's
mate.
That's exciting.
So it's just gone up and now I've just posted about it on Instagram so everyone knows to go and watch our fucking YouTube. Watch our fucking YouTube.
Watch our fucking YouTube.
People need to subscribe to our channel. Help us out. Get those fucking numbers up.
Like, subscribe, leave a comment. Wake up! Run, rush, and put a little makeup! Have the sense to fade away the shake-up! Why'd you leave the kids up on the table? Issue with my neck.
Yeah.
Base of the neck. So my tri has flared up with the lat again.
Okay.
I've injured that.
What flared that up this week?
The tri. Mm-hmm. Demonstrating a chin up.
Okay. How about the neck?
Jesus Christ!
It was. I think it was from back, training back.
Yeah.
It was probably a shrug variation on a calf press machine. Yeah.
Okay.
Probably not the best movement.
Alright, you getting any headaches?
It just feels, tension through there, tight, and it's just through the base of the neck.
Okay, yeah.
Feels like it's been.
How come you can't reach the neck? The lat's too small. Alright, let's go jump for off.
That gorilla spec.
Yeah. Looking over the right, anything?
To the back.
Yep, looking down. Where's the stretch? Yeah, looking. Alright, arms in front, thumbs up, lifting up. Yeah, back down, palms up. What are you feeling?
Probably through the right.
The front of the shoulder?
Yeah. You wanted to! Never rush you, but a little makeup! You wanted to! I just got
the fade away the shake up! You wanted to! Why'd you leave the keys up on the table? You. When you check to type 1 diabetic and wants to achieve a bit of a body recomp, so. Yeah, type 1's a lot harder to work with because obviously their body doesn't produce insulin and that, so as much as I do a lot of the prep stuff, I also take on people like that who are, you know, have a lot more specialty needs that you just like need a high level of knowledge to work around. But yeah, she should be pretty much pretty keen, so yeah. It's pretty easy. Like she already has a pretty good understanding. She actually does a vlog and everything of her own journey as a diabetic and that too, so another reason why I can take it on if she's documenting the whole thing. I hate to fuck that one up.
Yeah. Yo, I rose early morning, spread my wings yawning. Vague memory of last night, now it's all dawning. Look down to see, drop blood all on my garment. It stained on my guest farmers, kept it enormous. I hopped up, out of my bed, holding my head. Flashbacks of gunshots, shot past my head. I could recall, 8-man brawl, 3-man.
For months, you're fucked up.
For what?
This is your, you're looking forward to your session with Laura?
100%. Might have pulled the old standard. I've only got half an hour, Laura.
Needles, massage, cupping.
Every time I haven't seen her for a while, she goes straight for the quads.
Mm.
I don't hate the quads.
How are you feeling? Nice and loose?
No.
No.
I feel worse.
Sore?
Yeah. Because of eating needles and massage, it sort of releases all the toxins. And
yeah. Makes you feel a bit,
Go for a nap?
You can have a nap if you want. Yeah. I make sure no one fucks with you or messes with you while you're sleeping.
No, you wouldn't do that, would you?
No, I would. I'll keep an eye on you. I'll keep you safe, James.
Keep that camera pointed on me so no one comes near me.
Yeah, pretty much.
Exactly. Coming up PT session this afternoon.
You up?
Michelle.
Stack.
Yeah.
Right. Who?
Michelle Stack.
What time's that?
4:45. Mm. And I just got some check-ins.
Check-ins.
Yes.
Nice. Doing legs in shop?
Yeah, I believe so. Whatever she needs to.
Yeah, she wants to work on her quads, her hands are quads alike.
Yeah.
Train her clients.
Yeah, it's a daughter and father combo.
Oh, nice.
Both want to prep for season B, so.
Season B, is that
Like September, October time.
What federation is that?
Well, there'll be.
It just varies.
Which the. Monique, the daughter, she's done ICN multiple times, so we'll have a look at where she's going to suit better, whether she's going to suit better at ICN, IMBA, MBA. Her dad wants to do his first ever comp. He's been training for 20 plus years, so they've just been working with a coach that's kind of fucked things up a little bit. So at least they're reaching out nice and early, so they're 8 months ahead, so that's going to give me time to try to correct everything and then actually prep them in the show. But yeah, having a bit of a father-daughter combo should be pretty interesting going into a prep. So
yeah, that'll be a good one.
It was a good check-in. It was actually.
It was a good check-in.
He looks good. Yeah.
He always looks good.
Yeah.
Thanks, Busy. Transition.
Yeah. steps only count outside of the gym, right?
Yes. What do you think of his outfit today?
It's fresh.
What? Thank you very much. Thank you.
Maybe you should take a look at these.
What? Jealous?
You used to look good, but I don't know what happened.
What do you mean?
Oh, I'm so glad I was recording that.
This is
what?
What the heck?
What do you mean? One of your better clients?
Yeah. What do you mean?
You used to come in looking really fresh and...
This is fresh?
No, that's just like...
It's almost like he's got
like... Fuck, I haven't done the washing, this will do.
I got Jordan on.
Yeah. Even Taylor's having a little giggle. It's almost like he's gotten comfortable.
Yeah.
Comfortable. In a sort.
You fuck up. Probably going to wrap up this episode, so thank you for liking, subscribing and leaving all your wonderful comments. As you saw, we had a bit of physio today from myself with Miss Fox, Fox Physio. Saw some check-ins, saw a couple PT sessions. Keegan with his check-ins. We didn't see much of Keegan today, did we?
No. He had a lot of phone consults.
He's off at the Cairo getting readjusted and physio, Fox Physio as well. So, he needs to. He's looking large, isn't he?
Fuck, he's a big human.
In the words of someone, it said, looks like he's wearing a art smock. He's that big.
Oh.
I'm not sure if that was...
Maybe like a Duna case?
Yeah.
Throw blanket?
Like a 140kg fucking... Anyway. That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
Busy? You had a good day?
I had a really good day. It's always a good time with you boys.
Did you want to tell everyone how much caffeine you consumed over the course of the day?
James gave me 2 energy drinks, yes. I also had my standard black coffee in the morning.
Yeah, and did you tell everyone about your tea?
I had a peppermint tea.
Yeah.
But no, it was a good day. Thank you for having me.
No, it's been a pleasure.
I'll see you again next week.
Maybe. Oh, shit, we haven't told you. Yeah, we'll talk about that off air.
Oh, okay. Okay, bye. Back, nothing's happening next week.
No, we haven't discussed it yet.
Oh, so something actually is happening?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I'll stop recording. So what's happening next week?
Nothing.
I'm still recording. So, chiro and physio done, yeah?
Yeah, day of rehab. So, went to the chiro because we've back been pretty jacked up ever since we moved the equipment. I want to catch up with him fortnightly because any longer than that, my back just goes absolutely shit with the training. So did that, then called down to Laura. Chest and that was tight as shit, so she gave that a hammering. I think she needed my quads so she could have a laugh.
You said she'd do that?
No, as soon as I don't see her for a fortnight, man, straight away she's going to the quad. So, yeah, did that. She got me nice and loose, so she spent about an hour working on getting my chest and that loose. So, you know, it's like after the needles, you feel bruised and battered afterwards, but tomorrow I'll feel good. So, today you feel like a bag of dicks. Tomorrow, when I have to train, hopefully I feel loose and I'm getting into all the machines, so we should be good.
Well, that's good. And are you training tomorrow?
Tomorrow, yeah.
Tomorrow? Okay, good. Because we didn't get a session in today, did we?
Nah, today's just rehab day.
Rehab day.
And I had a couple of people join the team and that, so I had to make those calls, so.
Yeah, that's exciting.
One rest day a week, we normally put it on a Friday, so tomorrow will be a bit of back, and then Sunday, we've actually got 2 athletes coming down from up in Mudgee. Remember Josh and Kat?
Yes, I do, yep.
They're coming down because the 4 pieces of equipment that were replaced, they're getting 2 of them, so...
Beautiful.
They're going to come down late Saturday night, and then Sunday I'll take them down to Powerhouse for a bit of a session and load the equipment so they can shoot back to Mudgee, so...
Beautiful.
It's always good to catch up with them.
Perfect. All right, well, I'll see you next week.
Next week, man.
Next week.
Make sure we do a session for you next week.
Yeah, dope, yeah. Got to get something good in.
Absolutely.
Thank you.